Hello and welcome to our weekly update. Today is June the 17th. It's about 7 p.m. And last week we touched on our data synchronization, how we're going to talk with our devices and with the CubeSat. And then we also touched on some of the progress that we made assembling our rover, our ground station. This week we're going to dive in a little bit further into the communication between our devices and what our headers are going to be and our payloads. So if you just pan over here, I'm just going to draw this out. So let's say to start off, we have our main computer, and this will be our device 2, and it will be connected to our to the internet. This is obviously device 1. Our main computer will be connected to our transmitter. Right, this is our communication that we'll use with the satellite. This will be device number 3, and then we'll go into our. This will be device 4, which is our motion control. And then our motion control will talk back to with the internet. So this is for our ground station. And above, the other half, we're going to have the devices for our Coupe satellite. So let's say this will be our device 7. This will be our transmitter on the CubeSat. Here we'll talk with the CubeSat main comp. We'll call this device number 6. And then here will be motion control. Right, just to touch on the communication between here, that will be at, I think, yeah, this will be the link here. And let's say, so we're talking to device 1 from the, device 2 from the internet. What we'll do is we'll prefix that with 2. Then after that, we'll have our payload. This is how we're constructing our packet, our payload. And we're going to postfix that with 2. So that's, we're finished with that device and we can move on. And then 3. And then our payload will be in hex. So let's go A, B, C, E, 1, 2, 3, right? And then postfix that with 3. To make the system more robust, what we will do, just in case, we're going to, for the prefix of the headers, we're going to prefix the 3, the device 3, with another 3. So that way, we are certain that what we are sending is intended for device 3, and so on 2. So the same thing is repeated to for device 4, everything up top. But when we are ready to communicate between our Coupe satellite with the ground station, what we will do is we'll get a packet ready, and let's say we're sending 3, and let's say we have, so this is our 2 prefixes. Once we see a star like that, and that off with 3. Once we see a star, that's our kind of trigger to communicate with our Coupe satellite. And the way we're gonna package the rest, so let's say we wanna go out our CubeSat, but we wanna communicate with device 6, 8, or 7. We're throwing in an equal sign, and let's say we want to go to our main computer on our device, equal sign by the device number, and then our hex, ECA, 1, 2, 3, let's just say that, 1, 2, 3, 3.
But so that's essentially how we're going to have our protocol. Another thing that we need to touch on is having the link and the signal. Obviously, we won't be able to communicate between the ground station and our CubeSat on a consistent, on a gradual, consistent level. So we'll have little bursts, little areas that we can communicate. So what we've done is we've decided to put flash memory on both sides here. And anytime that there is an uplink, that there's a connection, what we will do is the data, the package will be ready, and we will start our synchronization. And let's say we get through, 10 bytes, we will synchronize, save that, and then we'll save the rest of the data until the next time we have a link. But this should go concurrently with all the devices. So all the devices are communicating, but in flash we already have data ready. And regardless of the communication between this devices or these devices, anytime that there is a synchronization, the data is being pumped and processed. So that is how we're going to address our protocol between our devices. The headers and the payloads. Next thing that we wanted to touch on is our GPS. We've actually realized that our this is our breadboard GPS. This is the raw makeup here. This main chip that is responsible for the GPS calculation. We actually knew that at certain velocities we don't get the full data, and I think it's kind of a fail-safe device. So our option is to go and work with this and kind of see the unknowns once we hit greater velocities, or we found another microchip that is substantially cheaper, and it has the ability to convert from analog to digital converter, but the drawback on that is that we'll have to do all the manual calculation, so it'll be a little rougher. So we're kind of in that decision phase where we're gonna stay with this, or we're gonna pay more to get a better chip, or we're gonna go towards this chip that we have here that is a lot cheaper, but we'll have to put in a little bit more work. So that is what we've worked on last week, what we've decided, and what else could I touch on? We've also purchased some hardware that we're going to use for our integrating into our rover, some memories, and so hopefully next week we'll have something more than just a diagram to show, something more physical, maybe progress with the rover, and hope to see you all next week, and thank you very much.